today we're going on an adventure to go and get my comic books. Yay!
Yes.
You're dramatic as f***.
I am.
Happy Friday!
What's up?
Or at least it's Friday where we are. So I haven't forgotten about you guys. I've been facing a little bit of...
existential crisis?
Yeah. Creator's block, you know. The only thing in my way is my own mind. But today I figured since, you know, I like reading and it's Friday and I need a fresh start, you get to watch us go and pick up our comics. And can we get tacos?
Yeah, we can get tacos. I'll put up what I was going to cook.
Or do you want sushi? Or we'll
figure out food on the way.
Yes. But I figured, why not try this vlogging thing? And this all will culminate, hopefully, in comics and a full tummy. Right?
Yes. Yeah. Camera block. All right, so we had to make an impromptu stop. We had to fix the nail in the tire. So hopefully we will stop having slow leaks in the car.
We are on our way to Cosmic Comics.
Cosmic Comic and Toys for all of your comic book needs.
Also, I would like to say that because I am an amateur photographer, I got some really cool photos too. I mean, I ain't quite a Velandez or a Peter McKinnon, but I think I did pretty good. Considering, at least for right now, most of our photos are for us rather than any clients. In the words of Nate Dogg, if he lived during COVID, mask up. No. We can cut that part out. Alright, so we made it to the comic place. Ready?
Mm-hmm.
So, I do have a question. Do you guys normally put your comics on your Goodreads list?
Where did you see a 10 and 11?
Give me a second. This, I kind of want Excalibur, and I don't think this is on my list, but I need to see if they have like the old ones first. They do have 4, 8, 9 here though. Oh, and they have like the new Mutant stuff. Yeah, hopefully we'll be here again before the next call.
Push.
Alright, so do you want sushi then?
I think I want sushi.
We just finished getting our sushi.
Well, we ordered sushi. We wanted to pick it up.
We just ordered our sushi. Waiting to pick it up, and we will have sushi and look at our comic books. Did we get sake too? Which one did you get?
At the Hana Fuji. No, excuse me, the Hana White Peach.
Hana White Peach? Yeah. Also, why do I have my mask on still in the car? I was photographing, which is why I still had my mask on, but yeah. So we have the Hana Fuji White Peach and sushi, and we have comics. I feel like this will be successful. Maybe. So,
we were going to show you guys the sushi, but we got hungry forgot.
It was good though.
Yeah.
Anywho, we're back. We have our haul of comic books.
I got Excalibur. Get that receipt. So, I have not been reading Excalibur up until now. I did not know it was out because when I started getting comics, I was up on to the lines and stuff, but now I'm not. But I like that they're bringing in a lot of their like old lines and revamping them. So I also saw New Mutants. I decided not to get that this time. But I am going to be starting that line from whenever the X-Swords crossover happens. I did sign up for that. But
yeah, I've been out of Marvel events for a few years.
Yeah, because he was following every single event, and we would go and collect our comics, and they'd be like $100-something. So we don't do that anymore. But like, these are all of my Excalibur comics.
Because you got,
and
what's the earliest one you got?
I'm excited with New Jubilee. Yeah, I got number 7, so
7 through 9 on Excalibur.
Yeah, not necessarily starting from the beginning, but
who's our writer and author for that set?
I do not know. Let's see. Howard Toe. Did this right? Okay, I thought so.
Howard Toe and
Arseniega?
We'll figure out how to say this one later. We'll like probably try to put a pronunciation.
I will dub it badly.
Yeah, we'll experiment with ADR for once.
Yes. So that's what this is. And of course I got my X-Men, which I've been keeping up on that. I have Powers of X and House of X that I do need to go back and finish because I kind of flew through those. But these are the newer X-Men, or like the revamp from Powers of X and House of X.
That one's mine.
Yes, this one is yours because I'm like,
I have my runs that I follow. So I'm an Iron Man fan as a mechanical engineer, my pride and joy.
I have a crush on Iron Man, but I don't really care about the comics as much.
So we picked up Iron Man 2020 issues 5 and 6. Mm-hmm. I'm honestly behind because I haven't been reading the 2020 run.
We're both behind. Let's.
All right, yeah, we're both behind.
we've been collecting them and just have not been catching up. And
yeah, we'll have to do like a whole comic book collection overview at some point. I think we'll have to do that one upstairs because I'm not hauling those down.
Yeah, that's a lot.
Yeah, but current run of Iron Man 2020 is being written by Dan Slott, art by Gage and Woods. I'm kind of excited to see because last time I followed the series was right after the recent Secret Wars Hydra Cap event, where Iron Man wasn't alive. So I'm interested to figure out what's going on.
Yeah, because Riri was Iron Man.
Iron Man at the time. Yep. So along with that, I had to, absolutely had to, after I guess like I'm one of like the few people that really liked it, but the Ta-Nehisi Coates run of Black Panther
and
Black Panther World, I love that.
Yeah, World of Wakanda, that's what it was. But yeah, World of Wakanda, I also really, really liked that. And that was Roxane Gay and Ta-Nehisi Coates. And I understand the people who grown up with like Black Panther not necessarily liking Ta-Nehisi Coates based off of some of the old Black Panther stuff that I've like seen scans of.
I don't agree. I think you're just wrong.
I'm saying I understand. I'm just saying, yeah, like, I don't agree either. But, like, he is a lot more verbose because he is more used to writing books and articles rather than comics. And a lot of people have issues with that. I also feel like some of the people really, because, like, the people who say they really like Christopher, I think it was Christopher Priest's run or whatever. One of those people that did like some of the like quote unquote more popular Black Panther runs, that was very Hotep-y.
Well, and even then, like, I think one of my reasons that I really do enjoy the Ta-Nehisi Coates run of Black Panther is that he's sort of rectifying some of those past ills
that happened. That's up why, to that point. That's why we liked it. Because it's just like, I looked at it and I was like, oh, so glad they didn't put that part in the movie. So glad. that part in the movie?
Like him
the,
going
the
back.
Child, the Dora Milaje being child brides and like the original quote unquote like adaptation or not adaptation, but source material for Nakia. We don't need that in the movies. Like Marvel Cinematic Universe, Kevin Feige, if you're listening, please don't put that in.
Well, it already isn't in.
I know. Just making sure that it doesn't come in later and just like, well, they might not put the backstory in, but like they could quote unquote do if, especially since they're bringing in the X-Men, that whole like Nakia goes, we don't need that in that story.
I wouldn't mind like the evil Nakia storyline. I wouldn't mind the evil Nakia storyline because one, but Lupita said herself that she wants to do the evil Nakia storyline.
If they do it, they need
a different motivation.
Thank you.
Okay. Let me get there. I just want a different motivation.
Our whole marriage was hedging on what he was going to say.
Nakia makes a really good bad guy.
She does. Like, she did a really good job in Us as far as, like, whatever. But yeah.
See, playing Red? Yeah.
Yeah. It can't be whatever the fuck that was in the comics.
Her being jealous of, like, the random girl that he fell in love with. Like, that.
Yeah. And at least in this one, though, like, there's an actual, like, relationship in there. So I guess even if they did do the jealousy aspect, it wouldn't be as bad. Versus in the comics, it's just this random 16-year-old, less than that, this grown man and becoming a stalker / trying to be serial killer.
So
there was a lot.
All that to come back to say. Also, like, one of the other things I enjoyed of it was, like, sort of I don't know if I'd say the rectification, but the closure. I don't know if you can even say closure, but like the handling of the relationship with Aurora between Aurora and T'Challa.
I will say one thing that I liked, and I know other people had issues with this. I like that they showed a more human side of T'Challa, where it's just like, what I was saying before our air conditioner like so rudely cut us off is, I really like the humanization of T'Challa. I understand that people were just like, oh, we want this, like, confident king and stuff like that. And I'm like, you could be confident and still have lapses in confidence.
And he had failures. He's had quite a few failures. Like,
and I like his internal monologue of, like, I don't know if I made the right decision. I don't know if I'm leading this country the right way. I'm, like, looking for guidance. So I don't get me wrong, I understand people who were fans of Black Panther up until now. This is a stark change, and generally we're all people of, like, and I'm saying this as a person who, just like, anytime there's a change with Storm that I'm not quite a fan of, I get the look and I go and I stare in the camera like, so I get it. I'm not saying you guys are wrong, but I'm saying why I appreciate it. He's saying you're wrong. And I really liked the fact that, you know, T'Challa was humanized. I liked the fact that, like, the Midnight Angels, which were my favorite part of World of Wakanda, were just like, nah, fuck the system, going on my own. Witness to the shit. I also really like the fact that, like, there was a thing, and of course, when they literally wrote no one man should have all this power, I think they worded it slightly different. I had to play, like, I had to go back and read those scenes again and play that, because it was just like, that was the evocation of that song. And I understand that, like, you know, some people don't want that turmoil, conflict and stuff, but I kind of liked it. It humanizes. There's a difference between, like, what I think what some people thought that it was doing, which is kind of like downgrading or denigrating the character, versus to me where it's just like, a lot of these internal conflicts he has himself. The people in the country, there's a split. But to be completely honest, that's more realistic. There's not going to be any type of thing where there's like a monarchy or an oligarchy or any type of leader where it's just like everybody 100% agrees that this person should be leader. Where's the split? There's a lot of people who still like the way he was leading, even though he was having self-doubt. And I think that was done beautifully with Ta-Nehisi Coates' writing and Roxane Gay's writing, if you were reading both of them at the same time, which we were. But I can understand people who are not used to that, who want to see more confident, more quote-unquote kingly T'Challa, and were upset by that storyline.
Yeah. All that to say, when I saw that Ta-Nehisi Coates was picking up Captain America in the post-Secret Wars events, mm-hmm. I was very excited. So, again, this falls into my lapse in comic book reading, so I will be catching up in the coming weeks, and hopefully we'll have reports on like our thoughts and our feelings about the stories and arcs that we're following right now.
Yeah. And hopefully we'll catch up, because like we are really completely behind. Like, it's almost kind of sad, but we'll catch up.
We got the books, that's the important part.
Mm-hmm.
Hey, but thanks for coming along and hanging out with us for our little trip out today. Mm-hmm. It looks like the last little bits of the hurricane are about to roll up through here, and we're gonna batten down with some good books and some music and enjoy the rest of our evening. So. Stay safe, warm, and dry.
See you in our next video. Bye.
Bye.